took me to Munich when I was 4 years old, and I realized pretty fast, oh man, that's really some Spießer Scheiße, huh? How you say in English, extremely conservative.
I started beginning of 83, and a friend of mine told me some rumors about people in New York painting on trains, outside hanging on the trains while they're driving. And before that, we didn't have any information, we didn't see any train graffiti.
Man hatte keine Ahnung, man wusste nicht genau, worum es geht. Man hat nur gesehen, okay, das sind bunte Buchstaben, das sind Figuren und es wird irgendwie gesprüht. Ich war 13 damals, ich hatte keine Sprühdose, keine Ahnung. Für mich kam halt nur Zeichnen in Frage. Ne? Deswegen habe ich eben alles, was ich gesehen habe, dann eben versucht nachzuzeichnen.
I was sketching a lot, doing comics and everything. So that was always part of my life. But then I heard the news that there's youngsters painting the subway with spray paint. And just from the idea of it, I loved it. And so I went out bombing without any visual influence about how graffiti really looked like in New York. And actually it was July 83 I started bombing.
Stop fucking around and be a man.
Wild style, yeah, we took it as a fact. The whole hip-hop idea that arrived in Europe was really like a real culture. And so before we found out that how it really came about, it took a long time.
First time I saw Wild Style, that was definitely in 83. I think it was something around November, October on German television late night. I was co-financed by the German public television, and it was brought in at that late night show they called the kleine Fernsehspiel, like a sort of like side movie things, late to watch, not many people. I knew about what it was about, so I watched it, and that sort of was the first time I've seen graffiti. It was not somewhere that was basically the film Wild Style, but we hadn't had the chance to tape it or anything. It was just like you've seen it and that's it.
Du musstest ja wirklich zum richtigen Zeitpunkt vorm Fernseher sitzen, um das zu sehen. Ne? Natürlich gab es schon Videorekorder, hatten wir damals aber selbst keinen gehabt. Du hattest dann einen Kumpel gehabt, der dann, wo du Glück hattest, der das irgendwie aufgezeichnet hatte. Oder wenn du, wie gesagt, Glück hattest, dann wurde diese Sendung nochmal wiederholt und du konntest dann gezielt aufnehmen.
This movie had a lot of impact because that was the first time we saw graffiti in action. And it was shown in a couple of small cinemas all over Munich. So that's where I saw it the second time, third time, fourth time. And also in these movies, or like in the audience of the movies you saw, there was also like kids like you. Like, okay, these guys are also into somehow of a hip-hop movement. So it was quite a big impact in any direction.
Wild Style, ne?
Wir hatten das in meinen Augen Glück, dass bei uns in der Gegend sehr viele Amerikaner stationiert waren. Aufgrund dessen gab es Diskotheken, die halt häufig von Amerikanern besucht wurden, und auch eine Rollschuhdisco. Und diese Rollschuhdisco war einfach prädestiniert für Treffen von oder für Hip-Hop, für Breakdance, für alles Mögliche. Und das war das Roll-On in Wiesbaden. Die hatte so einen abgesperrten Bereich, wo eben nicht gefahren wurde oder wo man irgendwie nur seine Schuhe anzieht. Der war relativ groß auch und da wurde halt immer getanzt, da wurde immer gebreakt. Dann hast du die Wiesbadener kennengelernt, dann hast du eben auch die Leute kennengelernt, die auch in Wiesbaden gemalt haben. Dann hast du mal deine Fotomappe beim nächsten Mal wieder mitgebracht. Also das ist schon etwas, was da so langsam so entstanden ist, diese Szene.
First really impression we had was an exhibition in Galerie Thomas, which brought a lot of New York City writers like Days, Donley and everybody who showed their canvases. And Henry Chalfant had some photos of subways, which there we saw for the first time subway art. There was a copy of subway art lying around. And then we wrote down like the ISBN number from subway art, went to the next bookstore and waited 6 weeks until it arrived from the US, and then we were the proud owners of a copy of subway art.
The first years it was like really those media things I could relate to. You know, especially subway art, of course, you know, you see all those amazing pieces and trains and stuff, and you just, I guess you just start to imitate, maybe also a little bit biting, of course, because you're just naive, you just be like, wow, cool.
The whole train movement in Munich started in 84, like there was first a cargo train painted by Ray, then Cheech painted the first S-Bahn, like a regional train, and then I painted an intercity train in 84. And in 85 we came together with the Force, LOOMIT, HESH and Roscoe and Jolly Rogers. And we were seven guys going into the yards in Geltendorf, which is a really Bavarian village, very small. So it was a real adventure going through the woods and then into the yard. And then basically we had the whole night and like it was a paradise back then. We were very scared, of course, because we didn't know what was going on. But we could even go back the next day to finish some stuff on the pieces, you know, in daytime and take pictures.
It was a huge impact. First of all, the Vandal Squad was founded. The second of all, a lot of kids saw the newspaper and they saw it was possible to do in trains. And it took probably like half a year. And you were pretty much sure to see a bomb train in the main station when you were waiting. You had so many trains running. I mean, that was pretty much the high time there. And that was just like 1.5 years after.
Neon and I, we were in one class together. And in 1986, we made a school trip to Berlin. And already on the way to Berlin, like, we had all this fantasy. Berlin, the, you know, the big city, it must be full of graffiti. And we were very excited to finally see the big graffiti scene of Berlin. We arrived in Berlin and we were completely like taken aback because we didn't see any graffiti. The whole Berlin Wall was painted, but there was not one piece that we recognized. Of course, we took a break from the school. We stole some cans and painted a subway. So, which turned out later, which we didn't know, was probably the very first subway painted in Berlin with a school trip from Munich. Was very funny at the time.
Berlin was really late, you know, and this came because we were isolated. We were separated from the rest of Germany. When I started, Bando was the king from Paris, Chu was the king from Amsterdam, and I heard rumors when they were touring around in Munich and other cities, they were painting. So for sure, our heroes like Amok and the old Chaos and other old school writers from West Berlin, they were looking to them heroes here, Chu and Bando. For sure, they fit better to the role model, you know, because we are Europeans and we have also our identity.
The CTK came in 87. When they came to Munich, they were like in paradise. Like they said, like, if we have a train system like this in Netherlands, it would be completely bombed. And that's what they did. Like they went there on the trains every day for about a week or so. And they didn't only paint one piece, but then after painting a piece, they painted a second piece, and then they bombed all the trains with throw-ups and pegs and lines and, until every can was finished. And this was really something we hadn't seen before, like completely going into the damage mode. Also as a strategic way to bomb the trains, to get your piece running, you destroy everything else. And this is something we learned from them and from their action. But of course, it was Munich, so they were arrested after 1 week because the Munich police just went crazy. They couldn't believe what was going on and they really tried to get them.
Primetime Kings, big impact. Look at Mitch Styles, you know. The first contact were made like pretty easy, or they came to us and showed us, yo, this is bombing, this is doing throw-ups, this is destroying a train, you know. Munich is always the tendency to be nice, clean, colorful, perfect, straight lines, even on trains, you know? So they kind of showed us, yo, this is vandalizing the trains too. And this had an enormous impact because, of course, this is as important as to do beautiful pieces, you know, destroying.
Primetime Kings were sort of spreading out also to Munich and pretty much influenced the whole continent with like the first idea of an own style, of a European continental style. But it was always like after like a couple of months or so, there were people developing on the base of this style their own styles. So like Bando style was pretty much like the one in, I'd say, from 86, 87, the most influential in all over Europe.